and the next. Bando Chemical Industries Limited began 100 years ago as a power transmission belt maker. It has since grown into a top global corporation based on its rubber and plastics manufacturing technology. The history of the company's pioneering spirit originated here in the international port city of Kobe. The latter half of the Meiji era, around the early 1900s, saw the dawn of modern industry in Japan. Although the fabric industry was well developed, the steel and shipping industries were still in their infancy. At that time, an inventor arrived in Kobe. His name was Naosaburo Bando. Born into an old samurai family in Sasayama, north of Kobe, he left home at an early age and spent much time and money in Tokyo developing fabric belts. After using up all his money on his invention, he arrived in Kobe to seek help from the city's business leaders. He told them that machine belts are currently made out of leather and are all imported, but belts could be made in Japan out of cotton, which costs much less and will definitely sell. The enterprising business leaders listened to him intently. They said, "If we make inexpensive cotton belts, we can contribute to the growth of domestic industry and avoid reliance on imported belts." Hearing these words, Mr. Mitsuzo Enami made plans to start production of cotton belts using Mr. Bando's patent. On April 14, 1906, Bando Belt Company was established with 20 employees. The new company's president was Mr. Mitsuzo Enami, then 27 years old. Water and moisture cause serious characteristic changes in leather. Cotton is not affected in the same way and costs only half as much. The general manager, Mr. Mizusawa, vigorously worked to expand the company's sales channels. However, at that time, cotton belts were rare, and engineers and factories in the target market did not readily accept his idea, making it a truly difficult battle. Then, one day, something happened. The naval factory in Kure gave the company an opportunity to test its belts on the Navy's equipment. Needless to say, Mr. Bando was also present. The Navy had a new cutting machine for tempered steel. They tested a Bando cotton belt on the machine, and it proved successful at maximum speed. But just after they'd started celebrating, the belt suddenly snapped at the join and hit and killed Mr. Bando, who was standing next to the machine. He was 57 at the time. And the young president at the time, Mr. Enami, had no choice but to restructure the company. Operations at the Bando factory were halted, and almost 100 employees were laid off. All that was left was the equipment and unpaid loans. But Mr. Enami did not give up. He worked through the problem and changed the direction of the company. "That's it," he thought, and decided to use rubber technology to develop a superior belt. Mr. Enami decided to move away from relying 100% on Bando-type cotton belts and immediately began to collect information about rubber manufacturing equipment from England. 4 years after the untimely death of Mr. Bando, the company began producing rubber belts. Mr. Enami's dream had come true. The belts were sold under the Sunbelt trademark and were well accepted by the market. Bando's revival was successful, and soon after beginning production of rubber belts, Bando expanded its business with a variety of other rubber products. Slowly but surely, Bando's belt manufacturing capabilities improved, and in 1921, the company produced the first Japanese-made conveyor belt. In 1925, the conveyor belt's utility model was officially registered, and full-scale production began. Bando had successfully passed through the perilous phase that every new company faces. In the late 1920s and early 30s, Japan's economy began to slow down due to the global depression. But Bando had begun to use its profits to develop promising new technologies. Soon after, the company boldly embarked on the development of V-belts. Gathering of the necessary information and feasibility studies were conducted by the man who would later become the company's second president, Mr. Masanosuke Sasabe. Around 1930 and 31, Mr. Sasabe frequently visited the Ministry of Commerce and Industry in Tokyo. It was on one of these visits that he noticed a man on the train carrying a small belt. He learned that it was a new type of belt being manufactured in America. At a time when only flat belts and conveyor belts were available in Japan, the big difference in shape was of great interest. Upon his return to Kobe, he obtained a catalog and product samples and had tests run, discussing the results with his company's engineers. The product turned out to be a highly efficient belt developed for electric motor drives. Mr. Sasabe soon embarked on development, and in 1932, the first Japanese-made V-belt, the Banro, was produced. And in 1939, Bando established an affiliate in Korea. The following year, an affiliate was also established in Manchuria. Bando acquired the Nankai Belt Company and used its factory for the production of flat belts. In 1942, Mr. Masanosuke Sasabe became the company's second president under difficult wartime conditions. Then the flames of war reached Bando. On March 17, 1945, Kobe was devastated by a series of air raids. All three of Bando's factories in the city were destroyed. Equipment, products, and important documents all went up in flames. It was a huge blow. Standing in front of the scorched earth, Mr. Sasabe uttered the following words. "We must rebuild the company for our employees' sake. To reconstruct as soon as possible, we should start now with what we can." Fortunately, the Nankai plant had not been badly damaged. All of the employees worked hard together in a united effort, and things began to slowly improve by the time the devastating war ended on August 15th. The year after the war ended, the company restarted its operations in earnest with the manufacture of bicycle tire tubes and rubber bands, as well as motorcycle tires. While continuing the development of rubber technology and embarking on reconstruction efforts, the company also began to challenge new areas of business. Bando started to develop and manufacture products made of PVC, polyvinyl chloride. The company expanded steadily by catering to the needs of the domestic market with a new line of synthetic plastic products, as well as a diverse range of rubber belts, constantly pursuing innovation. In addition to rubber and PVC, Bando focused its efforts in the new area of polyurethane elastomers. In 1961, Bando worked with Bayer of Germany to develop a new line of polyurethane products. The new line of products was successfully marketed under the trademark Bancolon. However, at that time, the company's third president, Mr. Shoichi Inami, decided to streamline the company's operations and discontinue production in the footwear and tire businesses, which had begun to experience extremely heavy competition. Was also formally changed to its current name, Bando Chemical Industries Limited.
1. Troubles caused by belt deterioration. 2. When belt replacement is necessary. 3. Belt inspection methods. And 4. Proper belt installation. It may seem hard to know when to replace belts, but if a belt is used beyond the recommended service life, a minor deterioration can cause decreased fuel efficiency and unusual noise while driving the car. Further use can lead to more severe troubles, such as if the alternator does not sufficiently charge the battery indicator on your dashboard will light up, which actually indicates that all electronic devices in the vehicle are not being charged properly. Ordinarily, power steering allows us to turn the steering wheel easily. However, if the belt fails, hydraulic pressure to the power steering pump is decreased due to a lack of precision power transmission and steering becomes difficult. The air conditioner stops working and there is no temperature control. The engine overheats. It is always better to be preventative rather than reactive. Therefore, to prevent both minor and severe trouble caused by a belt, Bando recommends you to inspect the belt periodically and get it replaced at the appropriate time. Now, let's see what causes these conditions when the belt replacement is necessary. Automotive belt ribs become worn or cracks occur due to extended use and age. These are the signs that the belt needs to be replaced. Look for wear. Wear reduces belt rib height and width. As a rib starts to wear and flatten, it will lose its ability to function properly, causing slippage. Look for cracks or a glazed appearance. This indicates the belt has aged and is slipping or chirping. It is hard to see a worn belt and whether or not a belt needs to be replaced visually. Therefore, to judge wear on today's belt, Bando Rib Ace Belt Wear Gauge was created to provide a quick, accurate way to check whether a belt needs to be replaced. Bando Wear Gauge is placed on the rib surface. Apply the teeth of the gauge to the rib side of the belt. If the back of the belt is at the same level or lower than reference level, the belt needs to be replaced. Belt height can then be checked against the reference guide to determine if replacement is necessary. In this last chapter, Bando would like to introduce 3 consideration tips on how to install properly. The first consideration is pulley alignment. Misalignment occurs when there are errors in pulley angle, gap, or parallelism. Misalignment causes belt wear, noise, vibration, and affects belt life. The second consideration is proper mesh between the belt and pulley. Substantially less power is transmitted if there is an offset between the belt and pulley grooves when the belt is installed. And there is a risk of damage if the belt rides on the pulley flange. Timely belt replacement enables safe and comfortable driving as the belt maintains its initial performance. Bando recommends performing preventative maintenance and early belt replacement to avoid vehicle troubles.
a powerful passion to carry, transmit, and connect in response to the demands of the era, has successfully connected the past to the present. Bando is connecting the present to the future with new possibilities built on the demands of a new era. Development of high technology for the next. It has already started. Doing more on new frontiers.